Ever thought what preparation goes into rolls first and what we do in between the tiers? Let's talk about it. My name is Kena and I'm a main raider method, and today I shall take you through what we do to prepare ourselves for a roll first progress. I will be taking you a couple months back and walk you through to where we were then and what we have done in between. So a couple of months ago, we had the Eternal Palace World First Race. This was a great patch to take a prime example of. So the prep for this World First Race kind of started instantly after the one before that. We lost Crucible of Storms, and our guild does not take that lightly. We knew we lost and we wanted to avoid that at all costs ever again. We had plenty of meetings about what went wrong from many different perspectives. From going from the tactics, if you thought anything was wrong there, to personal performance of people, to compositions, to PTR testing, what we could improve there, to weak auras, to attendance of people, as good examples. A good example would be, for example, we stepped up our weak aura game. During Crucible, we really felt like we focused on the wrong things with weak auras. Instead of, for example, making a really good intro weak aura, we spent a lot of time on making a weak aura that we ended up not even using. So identifying what exactly we need excellent weak auras for was something that we did way, way better in this tier. After that, and besides that, there's also the PTR. After Crucible, we started testing the Eternal Palace. All the boss testings are completely public. Method does not get any special testing time or get to test any special bosses. We always have our own small weak aura packages ready for this. We all read up on the bosses, and we all start kind of slightly thinking ahead. So like, oh, there's this, for example, fear mechanic, can I tremor it? Maybe Spirit Link could be really good here. Obviously, reading up on Ashara, we were like, okay, how does Ankh interact with this? You know, do we remove the stacks? And when we Ankh up, does it stay or not? These are things that we think about and test a lot during the testing. We only have limited time on this amount of testing, so we always want to get as much done as possible. Scribe and Potter, and whoever is generally around, will always make a general idea tactic. It's mostly Maris, for example, that makes the weak auras that we do, and everyone kind of tries their class things to try and get as much information as possible. For Heroic, literally everyone of the raiding team tries to attend it, if possible. For Mythic, we always try and have kind of diverse compositions. We want to still go with as good of a composition possible, but we always want to really test classes as well. Since generally for Mythic, you get pretty high neck levels, you get high gear, you get, you know, you got multiple essences during the testings. So this is also a good fight to see where classes would stand out. So for example, it was really, really clear on, let's say, Queen's Court that Shadow Priests were going to be the king of the fight. So obviously we prepared a couple of Shadow Priests. Same with Sakul. You know, you could really see like some of the class balance that was happening at that point and what kind of classes you feel like are going to be safe bets. While doing the PTR, we were also doing our split raids. We were clearing 6 Battle of the Tsar Lords every week and 1 Unat. We do these for special trinkets, Titan Force stuffs, but mostly also for Vestadim, to be able to buy new pieces of Azerite when the new patch hits. This kind of stuff keeps going until the end of the patch. We generally only raid really 2 days a week, and we try and get all of the runs done in these. At this point, we mostly did the runs for just Vestadim, make sure that everyone has as much Vestadim as possible going into the patch, and being able to buy either multiple heroic pieces or being able to buy 1 mythic piece as soon as progress starts. During the patch, almost every single player in our guild plays non-stop. We mostly farm our main and main alt, and only do small things to other alts. My personal goals for this patch was to hit 3x 57 trades, for my Shaman, Warlock, and my Priest. Outside of the AP grind already being pretty time consuming, there was also Pearls. If you want to know how to effectively farm Pearls, I'd recommend you to check out our sponsor WoWhead. They have excellent Nashatar guides there on how to get as many Pearls as you humanly can. Basically everyone in Method was expected to get full Benthic gear before progress. For this we used many alts to farm Pearls. Basically what you would do in your alts is you would farm the Pearls, buy Benthic gear, send it to your main characters, and then open it on your main characters hoping for the correct item with the correct proc with the correct soccer. There was really no limit to how many Pearls you could farm, as any excess Pearls was turned into Residuum. This Residuum ended up being an extremely good bonus, as it helped off finish many pieces for progress or heroic week. Either you would save up a lot and buy a lot of pieces sent to your main, and be able to buy a mythic piece with where you normally would have had 2,000 or 4,000 resonum less, or you would send a couple of the resonum items to your alt and be able to get up to 9,000 resonum and buy the heroic piece before heroic week. Overall, I personally played about 14 hours a day on this patch for 14 days straight until progress came. During this time, I farmed AP, rep, essences, pearls. We were still raiding our split raids, and we were doing the weekly keys, obviously, as well. Personally, to even lower the stress, I started multiboxing. I have 3 accounts, and now I recently even started using a multiboxing program called IS Boxer. Just to make sure everyone knows this, this is fully legal. As touching on resonum, as method, we all have 6 characters at minimum. All of these needed 9,000 resonum to be able to buy an heroic piece on the first week of the raid. This is when the box gave you around 650 resonum or something. This is so when we were able to buy a specific piece of resonum we were told to get in that specific raid, either a shoulder or a chest. Then we would buy it, equip that specific piece, even if it's not an upgrade, and then you would be able to trade that specific piece to the mains. In order to make these splits even better, we also need to get an engineering helm on every single character. Engineering gave us a free 430 item level S-Ride helm, ensuring we could trade all the helmets in the entire raid to all the mains. All alts also needed to be full on coins the week before the heroic week. This is so that we were able to get 7 coins in total in the heroic week. So the idea with the coins is that we would kill a bad boss, a boss with really bad loot, over and over again, about 5 to 6 times. Coin him every single time and try to get as many bad pieces as possible. So the first time when you got a shoulder, it was a bad shoulder and you couldn't trade that shoulder. But maybe when we went to a boss that dropped a best in slot shoulder for someone and you looted it, you were then able to trade that specific shoulder to the main. And then the main obviously got a really nice big upgrade. Outside of and talking about the mains, obviously also mains wanted to be able to craft gear. For example, a lot of mains use, for example, leatherworking and jewel crafting. And this costs a lot of gold. I also think that we needed, for example, 6-time engineering on all our characters, right? So months before the patch, we need to start farming gold. Personally, I always try and have at least 2 million gold before a patch or before progress. I started this progress with 2 million, and after progress, I had about 40k gold left. Right now, I'm back up to around 3.5 million gold, just to give you an idea of how I farm my gold. Then there's, of course, progress time itself. Outside of the actual progress hours that we do, we still want to increase our power. For me personally, I always woke up 30 minutes to an hour earlier, got to the studio earlier, and started doing my AP swoops, just to increase the amount of strength that my character got during actual progress. As a good example to give, I started progress with 58 trades, and I ended progress with 60 trades. I hit 60 trades about 2 days before actually killing Ashara. During the food breaks, I would also farm pearls just to get my last few pieces from 420 benefit to 425. And a lot of people actually ended up doing this. Also, people that are bench for a specific boss will either be hard farming on characters that are going to use on the next boss, or they will be farming Mythic Plus a lot to try and get specific items, specific trinkets, maybe some Titan Force stuff. Obviously, this progress, we came out of top and we were really, really happy about that. This progress ended quite early on in the week. So generally what we do in Method is we try and take, you know, a little bit of a break, give everyone time to relax and catch up on stuff. Either go back to work, catch up on studies, etc. So we killed the boss on Friday, and the next time that we raided was the Tuesday on the reset after. So we had about a 10 plus day break. During this raid, we also had a meeting to discuss our future plans, and we decided that we wanted to start a little bit earlier with alts, and we wanted to get a general idea of the requirements that we needed. Quite early on, we decided that to set a bar to get every character 55 trades. This was super easy, by the way. Just to make sure that every character that we put in our raids at least has 2 essences. Since Method has a decent amount of streamers, a lot of people started doing the heroic fear runs. A lot of raiders tend to join these, and within 4 weeks, almost every single raider had at least 5 to 6 characters fully heroic geared, ready to go. We started our split raiding super quick because of this. 1 main raid and 3 small raids. The main raid would try and clear Ashara. I think for the first 2 weeks we didn't, and after that we started clearing it really consistently. This raid only is 1 day, so we basically raid 1 day and get as far as we humanly can in about 4.5 hours. Then the second day, the second raid day, we would do alt clears. And this is just the first three bosses on three different groups with only alts. The reason that we do these groups is because the first three bosses actually drop really good loot. You drop really good caster trinkets, some good healing trinkets, and in general some good Azerites and good item level gear for your characters. The bosses are super super easy compared to number 4 and 5, so they're kind of free and there's no real reason not for us to start this process. We do this for a few weeks to snag some early gear, while we were waiting for the AK to go up and people to still relax a tiny bit. Just a few weeks ago, we raised the bar again. Right now the goal is full benefic on 4 characters, and all characters having 65 traits in 2 weeks from now. This is to ensure everybody is ready for splits. We also have a lot of people doing war, basically getting benefic on all characters, or having even 6 or having even 7 to 8 characters. Outside of benefiting, there's also a lot of crafting here, basically blacksmithing, jewel crafting, and this will ensure people basically will have extremely strong alts without even having to step into mythic, allowing us to start splitting extremely fast and getting all the good gear. Soon, the goal is to start doing multiple Asharas, since our Ashara staff is really really strong and we want to have as many of those as possible. At the moment, we only raid 2 days a week, and that's the kind of the maximum we want to go up to. We want to avoid burnout at all possible times. So, raiding 2 days a week is kind of the sweet spot. I can see in the near future PTR possibly happen as well, and at that point, you know, you're gonna have to start planning around 3 to 4 days already. If there's something else you'd like to know, then make sure to let me know in the comments below, and I'll do my best to reply to some. This was Kena, you can find me over at twitch.tv/Kena. If you don't want to miss out on the next video in the series, when the next raid approaches, be sure to subscribe to not miss out. And of course, make sure you leave a feedback by leaving a like or dislike, or leave a comment below. Thanks for watching and have a great day.